So if you continue to be concerned with the ongoing worldly debate, there is an ongoing debate everywhere in the world, always, particularly in Western countries more than in Eastern, but everywhere. And what's always debated is philosophical, it's theoretical. What's debated is the nature of truth, the nature of reality, the nature of life. What's a human being? You know, all the philosophical questions. Is there life after death? There's nobody who can't list all the questions, but unless you've read tons and tons of history, you might not be aware that these debates are ongoing. They date back as far as recorded history and certainly earlier, and they continue right up until this minute. And there's never any conclusion. How can there be 5, 6, 7,000 years of differing opinions, somebody declaring, no, this is more right, somebody else coming along and saying, no, that's not true. So these debates will never end. If the world continued another million years, if humanity continued another million years, there'd be another million years of debates. And these questions will never get settled, because they can't be settled by discussion. They can't be settled by debate. They can't be settled by who has the stronger argument or who's making better points, because that's all mental level. And these questions aren't mental level. These questions are about the nature of things, and the nature of things isn't mental. So mental is just one part. So it's good to start to recognize that that's the nature of the conventional worldly approach to the big questions, and to recognize that that is an ongoing debate, never gets settled. People die over it, people kill for it, get killed for it, and still it rages on. So to the degree that you can recognize that there's no answer that way, you're freed up from the natural confusion of a never-ending debate. This doesn't matter if you're living a conventional life or if you're part of conventional organized religion, which is just a set of beliefs and a code of conduct, has not much to do with the reality of things. But if you're a spiritual seeker, and I only talk to spiritual seekers, no one will listen to me unless they're a spiritual seeker, so that means you. If you're in that category, and you are, it means it's to your benefit to recognize the nature and unendingness of that debate, and to kind of finish with it, to kind of not keep getting sucked into it, even in your own mind. And to recognize that the meaning, the nature of being a spiritual seeker, is you actually want the answer. Whether it's to what's this life all about, whether it's what's God for real, whether it's is truth attainable, whatever form the question is, the point is that you actually would never think of yourself or call yourself a spiritual seeker or someone interested in the spiritual unless you absolutely, truly want a real answer. And being part of the ongoing human debate about these things is not any way to get the real answer. And spiritual seekers kind of know that. But often they kind of don't know beyond that, how am I going to get it? So, to the degree that it's already clear to you, the only way you'll ever get it is through your own direct knowing, your own direct experience, your own sight that is beyond any thinking process. The debate is a thinking process debate. Two thinkers argue back and forth. So if you're caught in that, if you're not a spiritual seeker for real, then that will be a fun exercise. But for actual spiritual seekers, meaning y'all, it won't work. And it's a waste of your time, it's a waste of your energy, it's a waste of your mental gifts to even bother with it. So I guess this is a recommendation that you give up bothering with it as much and as soon as you can, because it leads nowhere. It's just circular. It's just trading opinions. So it's essential for any and every spiritual seeker to have a really, really clear comprehension that God, truth, reality, self, source, whatever you want to call it, and whatever people do call it, it's all referring to the same thing, is not a matter of opinion. Your experience certainly can generate opinions, but experience is beyond opinion. You can have experience that doesn't generate any opinion, that simply is you seeing or knowing or apprehending or directly contacting, connecting with, and an opinion isn't required. So what the conventional debate will never accept, because debate is a debate of opinions, what the conventional worldly debate will never accept is none of this is a matter of opinion. A spiritual seeker doesn't want a more refined opinion about whether God is real or not, whether truth actually exists. A spiritual seeker wants the real answer, the real, final, and true answer. So one way to start moving for real more towards the real answer is to start to understand that it has nothing to do with anyone's opinion. That opinions are simply a subset of beliefs. You get enough opinions and it congeals into a belief or a set of beliefs, and the world is always promoting beliefs and sets of beliefs. And beliefs are transitory. If you're born in one country, you are prone to one set of beliefs. If you're born in a completely different country, you're influenced to have a completely different set of beliefs. So it's quite arbitrary. It's not cross-cultural. It has no universality. And it is not a deep level of human functioning, human understanding, or human experience. Beliefs are quite cheap. So, you know, hang out with somebody a long time and you'll start to be influenced and accept at least some, if not most, of what they believe. If you intimately hang out with somebody long, long time and your beliefs are very different, guess what? You'll meet in the middle. Your beliefs will bend toward theirs. Theirs will bend toward yours. That's how pliable, malleable, flexible, and inconsequential the belief level is. It's influenced by every little thing. If you're having heartburn, you'll have a little bit different belief than when you're not having heartburn. That's how non-important it is. So all spiritual seekers owe it to themselves, are responsible for themselves to get free of the belief in beliefs. Beliefs are something you inherit. They're not yours. Beliefs come from the society, from your family, from your era, from your peer group, from your milieu, from your region, from your nation. You know, you can list 10 or 20, who knows how many, I haven't counted. Major influences that every single person on the planet has that are really the primary source of beliefs. You are simply a sponge taking it all in. Most of these beliefs go deep and are set in a nonverbal way before you can walk and talk. The base beliefs about what's going on here, so early that you have no way of forming a different opinion, changing your mind, until you're way into adulthood and start thinking about it, if you ever do. Conventional, the more conventional you are, the more you'll never think about it. The more you're burning in your spiritual quest, the more you'll think about it intensely and seek out how to get the answer. So the first step is to recognize, or that say the first step that saves you a lot of time, trouble, and fuss and muss is to recognize that it won't come through beliefs or opinions. Those are just mind productions, cultural productions, and don't tap into the actuality of things. So let me just say it simple, clear, succinctly, that there's no way to debate God. There's no way to debate truth. Your opinion doesn't have an effect on truth, because truth is truth. So, for example, does that mean ice cream is nearby? So, for example, let me think of an example. If you're deaf and beautiful music is playing, that's a fact. There's nothing to debate. Your opinion is not required. Either you hear the music or you don't. Either you're aware of the music or you're not. Maybe you're fast asleep. Some part of your mind actually will hear the music while you're sleeping, make it incorporated into a dream, or you're deep asleep and you don't hear it at all. Unconsciously you hear it, but let's say, you know, your main self doesn't hear it. So if you're deaf or you're fast asleep, snoring too loud, you don't hear the music, but the music is going on. So if you're deaf, you might have the opinion there's no music playing. But your opinion doesn't matter because music is playing. If you're deep asleep and somebody wakes you up and they say, guess what, there was just some beautiful music playing, you're still a little groggy, so you might say, no, it wasn't, I didn't hear anything. That's just your opinion. Your opinion doesn't matter because the music was playing no matter what opinion you have, right? I just want to make this really simple. So that's how it works with truth. That's how it works with God. That's how it works with reality. It is what it is. And it's not a matter of opinion. So, we all know that there's lots of opinions about all of that. But the spiritual seeker is better off once they recognize really clear once and for all, so they never have to think about it again. That's not a matter of opinion. It's factual. God is factual. Truth is factual. Reality is factual. Existence isn't a matter of opinion. The one thing you would never argue is that you exist. You know you exist. When you get up in the morning, you know it's you. You don't wonder, did somebody get up? Do I even exist? You know, when you're 14, 16, you have these existential, maybe I don't exist. But by the time you've been fired from at least two jobs, you know you exist. And you don't tend to question that in any kind of serious way. You have deeper existential questions that imply that, but it's not the same thing. You would never reasonably argue with somebody that you're not aware of yourself. The one thing you're always aware of is that you're there. So that's the personal side of it's not a question of opinion. You know you are. You know you're right there, right here, right there, wherever you are. Wherever you are, you're always there. So that's a parallel to what I'm talking about. That's a factual situation that is not useful to debate. Do I exist? Don't I exist? It doesn't, on a practical level, lead you anywhere. It's circular. Just takes you to other questions. And then you just get more confused. So you have to settle this question for your own good sooner or later, this question of how much of my opinion is reasonable, is leading me where I want to go, and the answer is zero. Zero of your beliefs, zero of your opinions matter in the search for truth, in the quest for God, in the yearning for reality. Your opinions couldn't be more irrelevant, and any beliefs you're carrying tend to operate as barriers to the direct knowing of what it is you're trying to know, or the direct experiencing of what it is you're trying to experience. It's not the road. Where you're trying to go, better beliefs are not the road. You can certainly cultivate better beliefs, but that won't help you to get to anything real. So it sorts out an entirely different way. In other words, if you have some sense of the reality of God, if you have some sense, or you can substitute any word you want if God's a trigger word for you, if you have some sense that truth exists, that it's monolithic, that it is actual, if you know that there's a deep, however you know it, that there's a deeper reality and you're trying to get to it, a more essential actuality, that sorts out very simply as either you have that sense because it's touched you in some way, or you felt it in some way, or not. Or not is all the people who live a very conventional view of life and don't question much of anything, believe everything they read in the newspaper, believe the cultural messages, and tend to accept some version of organized religion, whether they participate or not, as representing what might be the more ultimate facts of things, but they don't really get much involved in it. Even if they do, even if they become very religious, it's in a social context. It's not an actual quest for the majority. I'm not saying there aren't exceptions. But for the majority, it's not an actual quest for the actual truth because it's accepting a pre-digested, codified version. I mean, nobody reasonable and intelligent would argue that organized religion is not always in a codified form. That's just how you do that. So a codified version of the truth can't be the truth. And a preset view of reality or explanation of reality can't be the correct view of reality because it's preset and reality is too real for that. Organic. It can't be written out, here's the chemical formula, here's the explanation, whatever, and that represents what it is, because it's more alive than that. You can't pin down life in any formulaic way. You can have formulas that give you certain views of things, but you can't have the formula for life because there isn't one. So that's the fundamental, one of the fundamental arguments that people debate about how possible is it to come up with the formula. And in some eras, the answer is we think we can do it, or humanity will do it someday. In some eras, it's no, it's not possible, it's a fruitless endeavor. But the whole debate is stupid because either you yourself, not anything anyone has said to you, not anything you've read, not anything the society believes in. You yourself either have been touched by something bigger or you haven't. And it's no more complex than that. If you're listening to me, you have, and you know you have. So, to the degree that you can lose interest in the debate, which will never end, if you're waiting for smarter people than me or you to give us the answer, it ain't going to happen because it doesn't happen that way. You will have to get to it your way. And it won't be through your beliefs or opinions. It'll be through something much more real and much more gutsy and much more intense. And that's what you're trying to do. But if you can get rid of the belief in the mental answer, you're way ahead right there. Because then you're not barking up the wrong tree, you're getting sucked into how people who really don't care think about it. You actually care. So you deserve to be freed up of the fruitless debate.